Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Couch Bear Gaming. This is my first map at Stellaris, in which I'm a new player in these kind of games, and also a recently new streamer and broadcaster of games on YouTube. So, here's my first attempt at speech, so welcome, whoever's watching. And without further ado, we're going to start right away with the United Nations of Earth as the first game. And go with the tutorial. I'm going to try to comment as best as I can, so let's go. Okay. Options. Let's just go with default, I guess. I will do my best to entertain you as we go on, as I learn how to play this game.
Good day, Madam President. I am Veer, a prototype synthetic intelligence. My job is to offer advice and assistance as we seek our destiny among the stars. An excellent decision. You will have my full support. Building a star empire can be a daunting task. To help get things started, I will be providing instructional missions that cover the basic steps necessary to establish ourselves as a successful interstellar power. The situation log displays a list of all currently available special projects and various other points of interest. New items will likely appear as we begin exploring the galaxy. This is our science ship, which is used to survey astronomical objects such as planets in a star system. A planet needs to be surveyed in order to make its resources visible. Anomaly found. Thank you. Anomaly found. System survey complete. This is our construction ship, which is used to construct space stations. When an astronomical object, such as a planet, has been surveyed, we can order this ship to build a research station or a mining station to exploit any resources it may have. To overcome the vast distances that separate star systems, our scientists have developed the warp drive. Ships equipped with this device can travel between systems at velocities exceeding that of light speed. The Leaders tab lets us hire, dismiss, and assign idle governors, scientists, admirals, and generals. This is our homeworld and the capital of our empire. The planet summary screen, which we are currently looking at, provides an overview of the planet's important statistics. Surveyed worlds sometimes possess unique properties that make them valuable objects of research. These physics, society, or engineering resources can be collected by a research station. The resources generated by our homeworld will only take us so far. Luckily, our science ship has just found a resource deposit on another world. The time has come to use our construction ship to build a mining station. The technology screen is where we will be directing our research efforts. Technologies are categorized into three different fields, with each field typically having three available research options. Construction complete. Thank you. Mining stations are used to extract the minerals and strategic resources of the object they orbit. Military fleets are used to protect our emerging empire from threats, or to expand our glorious rule through force of arms, if we so wish. The Spaceport tab is where we view orbiting fleets, build new ships, and upgrade the station itself. If a planet has no spaceport, we can order the construction of one if we have the necessary resources. Construction complete. We see a visual representation of this planet's surface, divided into tiles. This tab is only visible on colonies and surveyed worlds that are habitable. Each pop occupies a single tile, which means that there can never be more pops on a planet than there are free tiles. Some buildings may cause adjacency effects. The tradition screen displays the tradition trees available to our empire. A tradition tree must first be adopted before any traditions within it can be unlocked. Tile blocker cleared. Construction complete. A research station built in orbit of a planetary body will gather its physics, engineering, and society research data. Research complete. Construction complete. Construction complete. Research complete. The species rights list allows us to customize the citizenship and living standards of a certain species, amongst other things. Research complete. Well done. The survey of our home system has been completed. We now have access to planetary data that the astronomers on our home world could only dream of a mere generation ago. Excellent. Construction has been finished on our new planetary building, and it should now begin producing resources. I can't help but notice that our navy is a bit on the weak side. We are certain to face many threats in the galaxy that will require some form of military response. Remember, the survival of our civilization is at stake. We should continue our exploration efforts. I recommend sending a science ship to survey neighboring star systems. Let us boldly go where no synthetic intelligence has gone before. We may want to consider building a second science ship. This would double the speed at which we can survey our galactic neighborhood. Construction complete. Situation log updated. System survey complete. Anomaly found. Situation log updated. The victory screen lists certain conditions that we can strive to fulfill to ensure that the legacy of our star nation will endure for as long as there is Double the science ships means double the fun. Oh, I haven't been this excited since we completed the last assignment. A healthy supply of minerals and energy credits is critical to the well-being of any interstellar power. We should take steps to increase our production of these resources. Construction complete. Construction complete. System survey complete. System survey complete. Good. We now have a small but capable space fleet that should serve us well in the event of any unexpected hostile encounters. Construction complete. System survey complete. Research complete. Anomaly found. Situation log updated. System survey complete. Remarkable. We have discovered spacefaring alien entities that may or may not be intelligent, but let's face it, probably are. Their true nature will remain a mystery to us until we complete the appropriate project to investigate them. I suggest we do so post-haste, lest they investigate us first. These are unknown spacefaring entities. We can learn more about them and maybe even initiate first contact by completing the appropriate special project. Construction complete. Special project complete. Thank you. areas of our empire are by no means final. Frontier outposts act as beacons projecting our influence into the void by building them outside. Construction complete. We have made first contact with an alien empire. These fascinating beings appear to have mastered spaceflight, just as we have. We should strive to learn more about them. We are losing credits at an alarming rate. Last month's budget report makes for some grim reading. Incoming transmission. A triumph. We have established communications with alien beings. What a time to be alive, or in my case, powered on. Research complete. Anomaly found. Construction complete. System survey complete. System survey complete. Construction complete. Research complete. System survey complete. Incoming transmission. Research complete. System survey complete. Anomaly found. Incoming transmission. System survey complete. Research complete. System survey complete. Thank you. Construction complete. Construction complete. This is where we manage all ground forces on this planet. The upper portion of this view is divided into three sections. The top section represents the orbital space above the planet. The middle section is the atmosphere, and the bottom section is the surface. Tile blocker cleared. System survey complete. Construction complete. Special project complete. Contact screen, we see a detailed list of all the various empires we have encountered. Their opinions of us are visible at a glance, and we can quickly and easily engage in diplomacy. The diplomacy screen is where we communicate with other civilizations. Here we can declare war, form alliances, and implement trade deals with our neighbors, amongst other things. Construction complete. Construction complete. Thank you. Research complete.